Shannon, I wanted to read this quote. In 2012, President Obama, after the attacks on Benghazi, said this: the future must not belong to those who slander the prophet of Islam. It's similar to the White House's response to the Ferguson attacks, right? Wave your hand at the police, but not the wrongdoers. This is not a White House that has embraced free speech. I mean, they've targeted our own James Rosen. So to see Josh Earnest step up today and say, we believe in free speech, bit disingenuous.
Well, and that quote, I think, from the president was given at the UN. So
that's
he
right.
was speaking out to the entire world saying, you know, it can't be about the people who would challenge these stereotypes, who would make up these cartoons and do those kinds of things. And there is a lot of criticism coming at the administration from the Hill already today. People, first of all, acknowledging this is tragic. We are with the people of Paris and all of those who lost their lives, the ones who were standing boldly for free speech and journalism, and also the police who were there to try to assist. But at the same time, we have Senators Graham and Ayotte, both Republicans, coming out saying there are multiple problems here. First of all, we have a very open visa process with France, so don't think this can't show up here very quickly and very easily. And also, Senator Graham specifically going after the president for issues on detention and interrogation, saying that is why we have to have those policies in place, because this was very organized. I think we'd all acknowledge, even with what little we know now, this wasn't lone wolf. One witness said they had a rocket launcher. These guys, as you watch the video, were very organized. They were very calm. They stopped to pick something up in the street as they were leaving.